Hey, what's up, everybody? How's it going there? All right, today we're going to talk about, I guess the graffiti that's out there today. Because in my live feed on Wednesday, I go live 9:30. Check it out one day. It gives me ideas on what to do on Sunday, like today. So the idea I got from my live feed on Wednesday is, everyone's asking, oh, who's the craziest graffiti writers, this, that, blah, 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 blah. And a lot of people say, oh, J.A. and this one and that one. I have to say, I think the dudes that are out there nowadays are much more wilder. Like, the shit they're doing nowadays, much more wilder than anything that people have done throughout my life experiences in graffiti. I go back far. I go back the furthest, as far as it goes, writing graffiti illegally. Yeah, at a hard level, yeah, that would be me. I go back the furthest. And I've been paying attention to graffiti a long time in my life. I've seen it evolve into what it is today. What I've noticed out there now is like a whole different level of graffiti compared to the shit that we were doing or would even think about doing as young teenagers. Well, I didn't do much until I was about 20 or something like that in the streets, because I was underground doing the subways until the subways died out and got all cleaned up, which was like 1989. And at that point, I was already like 21 years old or something. So that's when I went up into the streets. And in between, yeah, don't get me wrong, I've had spots in my neighborhood and in Manhattan shit that I thought would be cool, like along the river or something like that. I've done it, yeah. But I mean, as a, like a main focal point or something that I think I should be patted on the back for. Yeah, I picked up '99, '90 shit like that. Started really kicking it in. And there was nothing like this. It was all just tagged all over the fucking streets. Then people did fill-ins. I am still trying to figure out who. I've asked this several times, but I got nowhere. As far as it goes, who like really started going like all city with just fill-ins? I was trying to figure out who that would be. I personally think that would be Jaws, like with Jaws and Easy and them, because Easy, TK and them, TK also. Those TKs and those Jaws's, those were early on, and those were fill-ins that they were doing in the street, and even just the straight outlines with the black spray paint. So they're probably like the Godfather. I mean, don't get me wrong, you had dudes in the Lower East Side that were forever doing fill-ins down there, like the PR and stuff, and people smashing garbage trucks and shit like that, and even EL3 would catch outlines in the streets down the Lower East Side. So, but I'm talking about, like, everywhere. It would almost be like J.A., too. He was one of the first people that came out and really started doing all that type of fill-ins all over the street. But before that, it was just everyone running around doing tabs. And like I said, don't get me wrong, there's a few people that would do a wall or something like that, like down the Lower East Side or something. Hell, you had even dudes on the West Side, like First Class and stuff like that, IBM. They would do handball courts and shit like that, and like Sky's the Limit and stuff like that. Like, yeah. I don't know if that was permission or not. You had the Hall of Fame. But I'm talking about people who actually just start smashing shit with fill-ins. And that was probably around that point, like in the early 90s, 90, 91, 92. Cost was doing that, V for a bunch of people. And they weren't running around doing the shit that's going on out there nowadays, you know. Like, actually, if you think back, I could probably dig up a picture of it. You had a Lace, L-A-C-E, and a Neon, N-E-O-N, that was on the FDR Drive right after the UN building. Yeah, the United Nations ended, and it was actually almost like how Say, you know, Say City did his thing with Shadow and them down on, like down the West Village almost. It was like that. It was like a fence right up against a brick wall, and they did that. His blockbusters, like he was doing the train. That shit ran us there still till today. It's just you can't see it. It faded away. And he did that shit like, that was back in ESP days. That was like 1981, 1982 or something on the highway. Yeah, I got pictures of it. If I remember and I put it on or something. But, yeah, you had parking lots and stuff like that down in Chelsea and shit like that. People would go. I actually bumped into Omni once. I think he was doing, I don't know, some famous saxophone player. I forget the actual person he was paying. It was dead on. I sat there talking about it. I was with Just. That writes graffiti with me. And yeah, we were talking to him for a while. It was actually squash beef and stuff. I don't know, I don't care about all that shit, you know, joking around and stuff. And he was painting like a big army down there. Some hand, like a parking lot. It looked like a stencil. I forget who it was, man. It's a black jazz musician he painted. Did it real nice. I was like, yo, how did you did use a stencil? He's like, nah, man, just cut the shit tight. And I was like, wow, that's pretty cool. You know, broke out. You had people like that doing stuff. I would always bump into people doing big things down those parking lots down in Chelsea and stuff like that when I'm out there doing my tags and stuff like that. But yeah, nothing like what's going on out there today. Nothing at all. And that a lot is to do with supplies. First let me just tell you, I'm a little sick. That's why my voice might sound funny. I got the cold here. I don't know, maybe it's COVID or something. But yeah, I'm feeling a little sick. My son was sick, yeah. But he turned 21 on Friday, my kid. Yeah, Bobby Dyer, man. God bless him, man. 21 years old, man. Yeah. All right. Anyway, where was I? What was I talking about now? Yeah, the parking lots. I had to rewind the whole thing and watch it again. Alright, supplies. Yeah, the things are different now. You people got these crazy ladders that extend out where telescopic ladders or something, almost like a telescopic lens. How it goes, you know? They got these ladders that can go up real high. They got all types of crazy new spray paints that can write fat like this. And hell, even Rusto came out with something now. You could squirt that shit up real high like a fucking fire extinguisher almost. Fire extinguishers you got. Just you got so much different thing. I videoed some of the stuff that I've seen downtown, and these are on spots that are very, very busy. But these aren't like little middle of nowhere spots. You'll see how many human beings are walking around under the graffiti up high. That's another difference. People now are writing up higher. They're doing rooftops more so. A lot of rooftops are getting done now. More so than back in my days. But don't get me wrong, back in my days, we would get rooftops that would be like around bridges or like around the tramway. I used to like to get that. I used to love that shit. I tried to get them all. So you take the tramway across, it'd be like, arty, 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 arty. Of course, I never succeeded. I conked out after a while. They'd buff certain ones and stuff. I got pretty far. I had about five or six of them on the length of that shit. It's not that far of a ride. But yeah, I had big ones too, huge ones, like that shit down on the river. Yeah, stuff like that was going on. I mean, I myself, once again, speaking about down near the river, the one facing Queens and facing Roosevelt Island, that big RD I did with the rat, it's huge. It was the two biggest letters in the five boroughs for like ever. I mean, MQ came by and did it after it got crossed out. I did it three times. And I've talked about it hundreds of times. It's in my past podcast. I don't need to waste any more time on it. But yeah, that was huge. It's like the mouse's ear, rat's ear, about 27 feet off the ground. That was pretty big and pretty impressive, but it's been beaten, you know, by nowadays. I don't know about on Manhattan Island, but as far as it goes with the outer boroughs, by far, it's been taken. You know, you got people out there doing some amazing shit, like Texas and Gaines and that. Let me close this window. Yeah, someone out there with a car playing music. Yeah, so you got like Texas and Gaines and just so much different stuff, man. You got this dude Jet, J-E-T, downtown. I don't know if that's the Jet DMS guy, but it's a Jet, J-E-T, downtown, Chinatown. Yeah, I'll take a big, huge rollers, man. Yeah, then you got this other guy, Quasar, a Q, the letter Q, Z. A-R, I think that's, yeah, from my knowledge of what it is. There's one over here also, but it's spelled differently, Q-U-A-S-R or something like that. But, you know, them dudes, and then it's like X-S-M or something like that. I might be pronouncing the letters wrong. I'm just looking out my window because someone just waved at me. But, yeah, X-S-M is another one. These people look like they're using like mountain climbing equipment, like rock climbing equipment or something. I can't figure out how they do it. Not so perfect. They're definitely not hanging off the side like this and rolling down and doing it that perfect and that far down. Maybe they're doing the top that way and then getting one of them crazy ladders and doing the bottom the other way. I don't know, but there was no scaffolding there for them to do that on or anything like that. And it's huge. It's like down the side of a fucking building right on Canal Street. Yeah, nah, man. Fuck out of here, man. We ain't got nothing on that shit. I ain't gonna lie. The only difference with the graffiti, I mean, now it's more there. I mean, I might not like everything, but I do like that Jet stuff, and I do like that QZAR guy. Yeah, I like that stuff too. Real cool shit. Big ballsy out in your face shit, man. I love it. Yeah, them dudes are going off, man. And right now, it's like I said, it's like people using like rock climbing equipment. It's like the only way I could physically think of it being done. But you look at that dude's, oh, I don't know, I hope I videoed it well. I can only look at it in the sunlight, and I didn't really, I got it once or twice. Hopefully you'll be able to see it. But you look at that dude's, oh, it's perfectly round, man. It literally looks like some kind of, like a Xerox machine printed that shit on the side of a fucking building. And he ain't do that shit fucking around upside down, going backwards like this with a fucking roller. He ain't do it that way. He don't get it that perfect like that. No, that does not happen. I mean, it looks almost like some kind of like a sticker or something, like maybe like a wheat paste O. I'm bugging on that shit, but it's not, because it's really transparent. It's red ink. Like red paint, but almost like a red ink, which means it's watered down. It's like a dye or something. It's not, or just a thin, cheap type paint. But yeah, it's very interesting because it's transparent. Like you can actually see the brick and the facade behind. So it shows through, but still it's clear as fucking day. Yeah, you got some wild shit going on downtown right now as I'm speaking. So those dudes take it. Like you really sit down and think about it. Like I was saying in my live feed, everyone's, oh, J.A. this and this one, that, and PK and Kid. Now, PK and Kid, they definitely would hold that title up until now-ish. Yeah, they would. I'd say that PK and Kid, they were climbing around doing some wild fucking shit. I don't know the guys, never met them. They were doing some pretty impressive shit that I would assume they were using some kind of rock climbing equipment. But, as far as it goes to J.A., no, I believe Anso, A-N-S-O, I believe he passed J.A. a while ago, man. As far as it goes with the amount of damage in the streets, yes, it's different locations. It's not like gates right in your face, but that fucking dude Anso, it's everywhere. Like, villains are everywhere. Like I said, I watch crime dramas on YouTube, and they're looking up where, like, some mafia guy got killed and shit. In the background, it says one of the ANs and shit. And it's like, even in my video footage, you'll see it. It's just like Anso, yeah. No, I'm sorry to say that. J.A. never did no shit like that by far, man. Hell no. No, you people, I mean, you've got legendary things in your minds, like even you guys said Revs, this and that. Revs would count somewhat for some stuff like that. Like what he was doing with Cost, that shit too, a lot of that shit was right up in your face, like Chelsea and shit like that, downtown, Chinatown, right there near Bomb the System, the graffiti store. Yeah, that shit's like prime in your fucking face, huge shit. Yeah, Cost, he still hangs in that category. But as far as it goes with J.A., man, I'm sorry, he's been blown away a while ago. In my personal opinion. Now, you didn't even think, if I close my eyes and think back when I first saw that weird looking N, the A and the N, which I personally never even knew it said an A and an N until that guy Toaster went over me and stuff like that. I thought it said something else. And a couple of the bubble letters look like that, like the guy that does that weird G thing also. So I might be crisscrossing in my mind, but I could think back to when I was near So's house, So TNS, when he was living up in Harlem, right there. It was a fenced-in area, and it said that A-N-S-O stuff. He had a straight letter and then one of them fucking things. Yeah, I'm like, holy shit, that goes back pretty far, man, probably about 8-10 years, maybe. I mean, J.A. really did just write, like, from, I don't know, he disappeared by 90-something, and he didn't come back around for, like, fucking decades, y'all. The same with Easy. I'm just being truthful. So, I mean, yeah, J.A. would have the longevity. But, you see, I think he's been knocked out the box at this point. There's nothing J.A.'s done. I mean, this guy Anso has got tunnels and shit like that, too. That's my personal opinion, man. I actually have been around a long fucking time, and I've seen a lot of fucking graffiti. And that's my personal opinion on it. And it's a pretty good, educated opinion, to be truthful with you. As for what's going on now, all right, let's take into consideration, yeah, the pandemic. Right? Okay, yeah, so, yeah, people lose points for shit like that. But still, yo, you get it while you can, man. You can't knock someone just because the world turned upside down. Just because they fucking tightened up their shoes with laces and they went for theirs. You can't knock that. Yeah, I mean, I'm old school, don't get me wrong. But I'm really am being truthful here. If I don't say this, you guys will be like, come on, man, Ralph's full of shit. Like, there's no way I could say that anything that was being done back then is more so than now, other than war and beef. Yeah. War and beef has been taken out of the graffiti game. So the fact that war and beef has been taken out of the graffiti game, that's where JA stands ahead. As you gotta realize, man, that dude, like me, had beef with like everybody. Like he was a dick. He had beef with a lot of fucking people. And they were smashing his shit like nightly. You know, not like, oh, this, that. You're talking nightly. He had people, he even had people like that I know and shit like that. And even me, if I came across it, he had people out there just going over him and going over him and going over him. And he continued to go and go and go. And then he just disappeared. You get me? So yes, he had a lot of fucking beef. I mean, he created a bunch of shit in California, but I don't know. I don't think of one I don't know of. So I'm New York, and he really hasn't popped back up around here for a long fucking time. So you would have to say that J.A. might still have longevity over this guy, but I don't think he's running out of steam or anything like that, in my personal opinion. He's probably still young. You know, he's probably still got a lot of advantages. He looks like he's got things figured out pretty well, this handsome guy. So yeah, I would have to say that. There's probably a couple other people I could throw in there too, just as well, you know, but... all right, now where were we? Yeah, tools, supplies, these big crazy ladders and shit like that, the types of spray paints they've got. The mindset is completely different. The mindset, completely different now. Back in the days, yo, these gates, keeps you thinking on the ground, driving, people driving, this, that, gates, the gates aren't there no more. So, the actual, the canvas had changed, and a lot of it went up. And it's also like you still got people taking out like Hound, Pear, and them, Tosa once again, Anso once again, Zamer, Rebo, those guys too. Yeah, they're nice guys. I met them. Yeah, they're out there too doing stuff pretty hard out there. Yeah, just so many people out there, like, they're doing shit like what we used to do on trains. Now, also, you gotta realize the train situation, like, the MTA, the subway systems, I think that their realm is safe. Like, I don't think that the dudes that did it hard on the subways, that, like, their crowns can ever be taken. Like, Min RTW, like, he'll always be, like, top dog of that shit. You know what I'm saying? People like that. Yeah, like, Crook, just so many different people who are out there destroying shit. Yo, they got that because no one could do that again. Like, I really don't see that ever happening again in the future. I don't think anyone could beat that. Now, as far as it goes with people doing the outside of trains, yes, you have people out there nowadays that are doing whole trains. Like I've said many episode after episode after episode. You have people out there doing whole trains at the level when we were doing whole cars. You get me? I mean, to my knowledge, up until like my train days, like 89, you know, I remember, like I said, Kane, I don't physically see that, but Kane on the 7 line, right? Then you had like the Fab Five, then you had like Van Lace and them, that one that was done, right? And you also, in between that same period of time, you had like Vulcan, Part, and I think like DC3, all those dudes, they did a whole train also up on the IRTs. From what I heard, I've seen the Vulcan whole car, but it got split up real quick because they did it on the IRT, and it's like in your face, an important line. You know, the letter lines are kind of crappy. That's my personal opinion. You know, so they're like, oh, we can't let this shit run. So they actually broke up the whole cars on a whole train that was done in the winter layups, I believe, up in Harlem, like on the express tracks. I physically have not seen it with my own eyes. I have seen about 4 or 5 of the individual whole cars running, but not in its whole sequence. Nor did I actually ever see the whole one that we did, like with Ven and them, the Lace and stuff. So in my whole lifetime, that was it. People had pulled off whole trains, like the whole 10 cars. Someone did a car, 10 whole cars, pulling out. Yeah, so that's it, 4 times in my lifetime. Now it's like, every couple of weeks, every month, someone's doing a whole fucking train. And it seems to have slowed down, or maybe we just become used to it, so they don't even publish it in the newspaper no more. It's become so common that they don't even talk about it anymore, possibly. But yeah, so I believe the train game, you got people pulling out whole trains, like I've said, nowadays. At least 3 times a year, if we're going to be, at the least. But at one point, it does seem like every month I'm seeing someone put this stuff on Instagram. And they're New York City trains. They're explaining New York City, this, that, blah, 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 blah. So that's pretty fucking interesting. But once again, you got cans that write like this, and then cans that write like a fucking Sharpie. So you got everything at your disposal, things that we didn't have. So, of course, that cuts time and efficiency and everything like that. You got better everything. Better nowadays, better book bags, better communication, cell phones, everything. I personally don't know if I would have a cell phone on me doing something like that, but it's just graffiti. I mean, they're not gonna, but they do go that far. If they got nothing better to do, they do go that far. Like, they'll start tracing your cell phones and fucking with your shit and trying to get into it and see who you're talking to and what you're doing and stuff. Yeah, I've heard about cases like that, but I don't know what else to say about the whole topic. Yeah, we'll leave it there. One thing I do want to say, I don't know, I stopped this in between, but I don't know if you noticed, I'm a little sick. Yeah, my voice is a little sick. All right, guys, take care of yourselves. Watch the footage. You'll see how Manhattan is right now. Like, this is footage that's going on right now.
Hey, well, I caught me some people painting the Bowery Wall. I'm going to go fuck with them, though. Shh. Big dog, come on. See what's going on.
Where you can settle there so like he can have property.
You write graffiti, yo?
Yeah.
What do you write? You ever see RD, yo?
What's up?
You write graffiti?
I'm a sign painter.
Oh.
Do you do graffiti?
Yeah, man.
Cool. What's your graffiti name?
I write RD.
RD
357, real deal, yeah.
Hell yeah, real deal.
Rabid dog.
Nice to meet you, man.
You ever see me up?
I definitely seen it.
Yeah. I got a YouTube thing, you can look it up.
You do it?
Yeah, I do YouTube.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, man, I thought you were one of these guys out here, you know? Because I know Duster came out, and he was up here doing something on the wall. And that Optimo guy, too, right?
I mean, I'm sure he'll be back, right?
Yeah. You know, I was thinking about going back. I said, oh, shit, you know? I got arrested in 2017, so I don't know. I don't want no problems, you know? But, yeah, I think it's kind of free. How do you guys get to do it?
Got a permission.
All right, man, let me get out of here, man. Yo, look at my YouTube, RD357, man.
One more time.
Check that spot out, man. I don't know, it's very sunlit. But tell me, no, that ain't a spot to do some nice fucking graffiti. Look at the whack shit they got there, man. Look at that shit. Like, yo, how beautiful of a spot is that, man? Look at the church all ripped up, man. Oh, come on, that's some apocalyptic shit. And they got asshole shit like that. Just to let you know, 7th Street and 2nd Avenue. And it's wasted, man. You know, you look at that shit. I bet your boys like Gaines in Texas can hook that fucker up real flat. But yeah, I'm gonna show you guys some more stuff, man. Yeah, people living in Canal Street, Chinatown. This place has got a lot of graffiti everywhere, yo. I'm gonna show you the video. There's just so many people. Tell me these ain't hot targets. Look how many fucking people there are. To get to see this graffiti every fucking day, man. Like, yo, we weren't doing shit like this when we were younger. Nah, the newer generation took us by far a while ago. This pandemic? Yeah, come on, man, be real. A lot of you guys, oh, J.A.'s the hardest bomb of the sound of my live chat. Now, just, like, look at what's going on around here, man. You're, like, bugging, man. Yeah, this shit is crazy. Yeah, no, I've never seen shit like this going down, man. Just look at these spots. Look how many people are. Of course, they're doing them at night and stuff like that. Let me show you more stuff. This is Canal Street on Chinatown. I don't like to be here with my camera out too far, so I'm gonna pickpocket me. I think I'm a tourist. I think I'm one of them Bibbly Boo Von Zay motherfuckers. Alright, now check this out. This is still on Canal Street. Lafayette Street and Canal. Look at that, man. Yo, we weren't doing stuff like that back in the days. You know, a lot of people say all this, that, and talk all this shit, but I'm gonna be truthful. I don't know, man. What's going on now is something I've never seen before in my life. And, yo, with that said, think about how long I've been in the game, man. Yeah, pandemic or not, man. Yeah. A lot of it's bullshit, but yo, come on. Yeah. It's the spot, man. That's the shit. No, just look at this, man. This is the old Bowery Savings Bank. This is a fucking landmark, man. Look at that shit. Like I said, I hear y'all shit. Different level than what we were doing back in the days. Let me show you a bunch of examples, man. You gotta realize this is downtown, very busy. Look at all the people all over that place, for all the people that don't know. Okay. And that way is the court system. I'm actually almost not even in Chinatown no more. Back over my bike. Hey, you like that, right? With my little hat on and shit? Yeah, man. This is off of Hester Street. This guy jets me. He's up every other night. I'm trying to find these other spots I saw during the week. They're down that way now. I got to go more east. Bear in mind, people, I'm, right in my fix. I don't want to drop this camera, my son will kill me. Move right off Pike.
Yo, look how old this tree is, watch. Look at this, watch. Look how that shit is. Look at that, it's rooted into the fucking fence. How cool is that, man? That's old school, right? Look at that. Yeah. It's actually become part of the fucking tree, man.
See, look at that jet stuff again, look at that old. He got this guy put, I like that. Now we're kind of getting deep into Chinatown. Yeah, look at this. Okay, look at the train. Y'all can't see it. Like this back in the days. Well, you know what it was? A bunch of tags. It wasn't all these big old fucking blockbusters and fillers all over the fucking place. Like, I remember this place, but I used to have that rooftop up there. I could put a picture of it where Baron came with me, and above it it says Espo and Amaze. That's that same rooftop right there. Yeah, let's get a better angle of it. Look at that. And that place was kind of smashed back in the days. Espo and Amaze had it, I had it, and a bunch of other people. But yeah. It's the same rooftop, but now everywhere it's like smashed. I remember some of these blocks, like on Canal. There's that jet again. I remember on Canal back in the days, man. You could barely even catch one little tag. You try to catch a tag with a marker, just shit in a pill. Like during the Giuliani administration. One sec. They still got a couple of the mom and pop. Actually, this whole joint, yeah. Back in the days, yeah, this place used to be fucked down. Like, connected wise. Well, not fucked up in a bad way. I guess that is a bad way. You know, like corruption, organized crime. Yeah. See, so yeah, back in the days now, it was just a bunch of tags. you guys can see the stuff under the stuff. Like there's actually more graffiti on top of the graffiti of the brick building and the metal structures. And we'll go right off and find some more spots. A train coming. Woohoo! Dude, jets up everywhere, man. Big huge show again, all these rooftops. I just don't remember where. It was all over, man, like block after block. I think as I head uptown further. Remo, huh? Remo's up there. I haven't seen that dude in decades. I guess he's still writing, huh? Remo. The upstarting at the graffiti. I gotta give my brother some shine. He's been out there, man. Hell yeah, right? Oh, he hit something. Okay. Real, as far back as I can think, sent for me out there writing. Man, dude, he might not love me, but he does his thing, man. I have more in common with him than anyone else out here. Yeah, buildings in the background is the court buildings. Real, I told you, I just noticed that's actually a jet under there, too. Look at that. Oh, that's good, man. I like to see the graffiti wars, man. You know, that's really battle tested. You know, you get your props. But I don't think they wrote anything. That's just one of them, art assholes or whatever. Like, there's no points in that. You didn't leave your tag or nothing. So, my opinion. Keep going. Yeah, I don't know if I got that before. I had a thing with these cops over here. But, alright, so here you got Joe G and A.N. Anso, right? That's fucking cool. Look what that shit is, man. Like, full bash, man. That shit is crazy. Yeah, back in my day, we weren't doing stuff like that. I ain't gonna lie. You know, these guys take the cake when it comes to people like little old me. Yeah. And climb, you know, I mean, I don't know, fire escape, climb up. I mean, there's pictures of them, but not at these kind of levels, not the amounts these people are doing. Yeah, buildings in the background is the court buildings. Yeah, like I told you, I just noticed that's actually a jet under there, too. Look at that. So, fuck it, man. That's good, man. I like to see the graffiti wars, man. You know, that's really battle tested. You know, you get your props. But I don't think they wrote anything. That's just one of them, art assholes or whatever. Like, there's no points in that. You didn't leave your tag or nothing. So, my opinion. Keep going. I remember when Espo first came around, he had the little thing right here on this wall here. I crossed this shit out. All the way hidden back here. Now look at the type of shit people are doing out here, man. Yeah, you got Toaster up in here, Xaver, Anger, even this truck. It's pretty cool. Thank you. Yeah, pretty cool, man. Yeah, the fucking guy went over me. Let me not gas him up too much. But yeah, it's nice, man. Look at that, nice straight letters. Yeah, that's just perfect. I like that E on that Xaver. Real nice. Yeah, they come a long way. Yeah, look at that shit, huh? Yeah, it's always a little faded, but that teacher.
People, I hope you enjoyed that little fast motion thing. It's all filmed down pretty much around Chinatown. And all right. Take care of yourselves. Yo, don't forget my Patreon, man. Click on my Patreon. I got a lot more stuff going on there, too. Yeah, a lot of good footage. Never seen before footage.